Okay, so this is my spoiler talk for the Avengers Endgame. If you haven't watched the movie, please leave this video. I'll put my thoughts at the beginning of the throughout this whole video, but with the spoilers. So if you haven't watched it, please leave. And now let's get started with my thoughts on the Avengers Endgame. Yeah, guys, after a year, after a snap, we are finally here, Avengers Endgame. And honestly, I think that this movie is a very satisfying conclusion after the Infinity War. I didn't really do many videos about Marvel Cinematic Universe, but I'm a big fan of it. I think it's something really special in the blockbuster genre, like in the history of blockbusters. Like, there's something that will happen probably again, but this is the first time it ever happened in this giant cinematic universe. And Endgame, yeah, it was a satisfying conclusion, and I have had problems with this movie that I will talk about in this video, but yeah, I really like this movie. Like, it was very good and maybe even great movie, but I will leave it at the very good mark. So yeah, this movie is clearly for me like separated into the three like segments. Like, the first segment is most dramatic, you know, like when we see characters after the snap, we see how they killed Thanos, like with the whole Infinity Stones thing, like because he destroyed it and they don't know what to do. Now, like, they must just accept that half the population is now dead. I really like that segment. Like, my favorite segments of the movies are the first and the third segment. I'll talk about the second segment, but now, yeah, now the first segment. Like, the drama for these characters felt real, and the places they went after that 5 years time skip was really interesting. Like, Tony Stark, like, he has a daughter. Like, Captain America, who is kind of like he can't fight anymore because, like, there is nothing to fight really, but he's still trying to help. Like, the Black Widow. Hawkeye was like really cool scene with him and the Yakuzas. But the two characters I want to talk most about in that segment were the Thor and the Hulk. And I think that the places, like when I saw Professor Hulk and when I saw Thor, I was very surprised with their transformations, and I actually enjoyed it at the beginning of the movie. The thing is that they didn't evolve anywhere from that point in the movie, and that it was really disappointing for me. But at the beginning, like watching Thor like this now, like fat dude that like plays Fortnite and drinks all the time, because I truly felt for the guy because he missed that shot on Thanos, and the Hulk is now like the Professor Hulk. Like, interesting, because Hulk was very like hard the character to do in these previous movies, and I think that this is one interesting form of him, at least, you know. And yeah, it was really cool to see all of them, all the characters in these different places. And I felt like the dialogue was pretty good in this segment. I felt like that at the beginning with the Hawkeye and his daughter, like that was such a great scene. And we are going to the second phase of the movie, and yep, this is where I kinda the movie kinda gets too fan servicey for me, and like too convoluted. Out of all this, like when they are going back to time, out of all these missions, I honestly only enjoyed the segment with Tony and Howard Stark and Black Widow and Hawkeye. Everything else for me was kinda, I won't say disappointing, but like with the fight with the Captain America, and Captain America could be so much better, but it looked like shaky cam. And yeah, cool Hulk Hydra is the cool scene, but like it was so convoluted for me, and I didn't really care for it that much. My second problem is honestly the character of Thanos, that I feel in this movie was kinda, I won't say just like lame, but compared to the last movie, he kinda didn't have that personal connection with our heroes. Like, for example, I think that like in Infinity War, when he said like Stark, and you know me, yeah, like you're not one the only one cursed with knowledge. Like, he was just he didn't have personal connection with our heroes, and that was kind of a bummer. And I really didn't like how he said like I'll now completely destroy this world and create a completely new one. Like, that's just like that's completely like I could get behind his motives in the first movie, like destroy half a population so the other half can live safely with enough resources. But like, if you destroy whole world and now create another one, it's just genocide and creating another world. Like, I really dislike his plan. And here we really see like the problem with the character of Thor when he went to Asgard with the rocket and when he met his mom, I thought that it could be really interesting, redeeming aspect of his character for like the mother to explain him again how to be a king, you know, how to be the real god, you know, like not the physical, like he doesn't need to be a six-pack muscle man, like, but he must have that to how to regain that, like his character in the Infinity War. And it was some kind of the like motivation talk from his mother, but not what I wanted. And the Thor remained for the rest of the movie the comic relief character, and I highly disliked that about him. Like, this really went from the Infinity War Thor that was such a great character to this Thor that was nothing more than a goofball, and I really, really disliked it. And yeah, like he gets like his hammer back, and like that in the third phase there is a cool scene with him and Stormbreaker and his hammer, and he has both weapons, but he gets so overshined by Captain America. And let's now talk about that third phase, which I simply loved. Like the first phase and the third phase of this movie, like great, great stuff. Like from the moment they all get back to the when the Hulk like snaps and brings everybody back, and like I can go on whole day like talking about how cool it is when like Thor got both weapons, and then the Captain America, like when he took the Mjolnir. My problem with this segment, honestly, only my only real complaint is the thing that the action in this wasn't as creative as in the Infinity War, and I'll explain it a little better in a second. But after Avengers Assemble scene, what was like such a great scene, like when everybody came, all the heroes in one army and another, like it was so great to see like two armies colliding. But the thing is, this wasn't really a battle as much. It was like we must get this glove with the Infinity Stones from point A to point B, and I didn't see the battle as much as like yeah, like the road from one place to another, and all the heroes how that you will get from one place to another. Like, I would really like to see, for example, rematches. Like, if the Hulk now after he lost, Black Widow, how he would want a rematch with Thanos, or like the children of Thanos if they fought against now the different heroes, you know. I would just love to see a bit more of this battle. And the second thing is truly that the powers here weren't as creatively used as in the Infinity War, because in the Infinity War, if you watch the battle, for example, between Doctor Strange and Thanos, or Iron Man and Thanos, it is so great to see like Doctor Strange like puts the like something mirror dimension to like block Thanos' attack, then Thanos creates a black hole, he throws it to Doctor Strange, he creates a butterflies out of it. Or when Thanos fought the Iron Man, like when Iron Man is creating all these creative things with his nanotech, I truly really liked and how that all looked, and a lot of it disappeared in this movie. And I didn't like the Captain Marvel segment in this movie. Like, she wasn't much on the screen, but I really don't like her as a character, so she was kinda. When she destroyed that ship, I was like, I would like it more if, for example, Scarlet Witch did this or somebody else. Like, I just don't like her as a character. At the end, like, but yeah, the battle was cool, although I think it could be a much better fight. And yeah, now we come from to the ending of the Iron Man and Captain America arc, and yeah, I think they couldn't get a better ending, honestly. Like Iron Man, I got really, really emotional in the theater while watching him. Like, he basically isn't able to talk anymore because he like thanked the power of all the Infinity Stones, and all his like the closest ones are like arriving and talking with him. And when Pepper says to him, "You can rest now," I was like, "This hurts like really bad." Like, the funeral was a good scene, and Captain America going back in time and finally living his life with Peggy. It was such a great character arc for both of them, like the ending of their character's arc, that I was just like really, really thankful that they got great endings that they deserved. Because Iron Man for me is definitely my favorite hero in the MCU, and one of the best casted and acted characters in the comic book history. So yeah, guys, I think that is all I want to talk about in Endgame, like this, my spoiler talk. I will make a specific videos about the character development of Captain America, Tony Stark, and the Hulk and Thor, and how these two kind of failed for me was unused potential. Endgame was everything I wanted it to be, in a sense of conclusion. I wanted some other things. I think that some creative, I have some creative differences with the creators of this movie, but they did a damn good job. And yeah, this is it for me, I think, for the MCU. Like, after this, I really don't think I really need to watch any more Marvel movies. But it was a great journey that I'm really thankful that happened. And yeah, Marvel was wonderful to thing to experience. So this is it for this video. I hope you have a good day. See you next time. Bye.